Hello, welcome. My name is Obidako. Welcome. I want to share with you today financial mistakes or money mistakes that a lot of us make. You know, a lot of us make mistakes with our money, and that's why at a point where we so much need money, we don't have any. You know, whether it's in our personal lives or whether it's in our business, or sometimes at the country level. So, my name is Obidako. Welcome. So, the first mistake that I think most people make is that we don't have any plan for the money at all. The money that comes to our hands, we have no plan for it. We just work. They pay our salary. We pay electricity bill. We pay the rent. We eat one year with it, and then that is it. So, we hardly have any plan for the money. And that most people, because whatever that you don't have any plan for, whatever that you don't have any dream for, then we can easily lose it. At least it's a good step to have a dream for it, to have a plan for it, to have some goals for the money. And then the next stage will be being able to follow the plan, the dream, and the goals that you have set for yourself in terms of your finances, at least having the discipline to stay with it. But if you don't have any dream at all for the money, then it's likely that you go and buy a car with it, you go and buy a house with it, you buy nice shoes, you know, you go for the party, or you go for what they call vacation, you know, because you must have your own, you know, targets, your own masters for the kind of, you know, at least financial independence that you want, the kind of investment, the kind of wealth that you want to create before you start to enjoy. But a lot of us would want to enjoy life, you know, at a big level, send our children to good schools, you know, drive nice, you know, use very good deodorant, and then when the fire is from the job, within 2 months, we can skip up that facade that we created for everybody. You know, because we didn't have any goals for our financial future. And the next one is trusting too easily with people. You know, we trust many people, so people ask you for money, you give it to them. People who don't qualify, you give them the money and then you lose it. Because most people, when the money goes to them, that money never comes back anyway. Because most people are also very much indisciplined with money. You know, so most people are also not truthful with money anyway. So one of the mistakes that you are likely to make is trusting the wrong people with your money. You know, sometimes the wrong people can be institutions as well. Some of them investment companies, some of them the places that we bought the share, or some of them, you know, they will use all the legalities, but they run them the way they want. They pay themselves big money, but they never, the share price never goes up. So that could be, it means you are trusting the wrong people with your money, or trust giving your investment money to wrong organizations as well. The next one is being too kind with money. A lot of us are very kind with money because you want to help people, and if anybody cries on us, you know, we help them with money. We are very religious, we're very Christians, so when, you know, they say that this money is going to build this, we give all that we have. We have no plan for the future. That will be trouble. You know, when you're 40 years, when you're 50 years, when you're 60 years, and you so critically need money, that will be where you will know where you invested your money. And so you can do good to people, but it should be a certain percentage, while you also work towards your own independence, your own control in terms of finances. Because if you don't do that, it will be a major mistake. The next one is, those of us who operate businesses, sometimes high interest rate can also be a very major bad financial decision that you make. Taking loans that you knew that the interest rate was so high, but you were so much pressed, you so much needed to finish that that project, you need, so needed to take that business, that you didn't even care of the terms and the rate at which you were paying that loan. Then later, you know, because no project, no business goes as you plan it anyway. So you took the money, they told you that 2 months down they'll pay you. So no problem, 2 months down, if they pay me and I pay them, I'll still have something left. And the 2 months came and they failed you. And now it has become a problem for you. Maybe even the collateral you put on it is gone. You're going to court, they are frustrating you because it was a mistake that you shouldn't have made in the first place. Some of them, the microfinances, the savings and loans, the people that we pick short loans from, You know, the interest rate 5% a month, 10% a month is crazy. You don't need to do that. It could be a major problem that you will create for yourself in terms of your business. You know, so financial mistakes that a lot of us make is that one. So if you want to stop a mistake, if you don't want it to be a mistake, then you don't really have to make it in the first place. And if you have made them, then you must develop a plan to, you know, try to retract, you know, track back and see where you can make some corrections. And so trusting the people you don't have to trust, you start to reduce those people that you trust. And being too kind, you have to start to have your own structures in place and having goals for your own money as well. You must also think of that and being able to reduce the high interest rate. Tell yourself, I'm not doing it anyway. You know, it's better you do businesses that you know you have some level of controls, you know, in terms of the money, than trying to just be. Sometimes it's greed, sometimes we are just in haste, sometimes we don't have our own principles to set in place. So, you know, and every now and then somebody will come and show you, the money in the first place. Somebody, Bowies, will come and show you, okay, I have a good business, bring it, and then you give it to them, and then next minute you can find the money that you work so many years to get. You know, so my name is Obinna Akol. Thank you very much for watching, and share the channel with your friends and with your family as well. Thank you.